The event cycler allows you to cycle through events over and over. It will only cycle through events that are being used, as long as the events are adjacent to each other. For example, if you're using group 1 through 3, then the event cycler will cycle through all 3 events. However, if you're using group 1, 2, and 4, then groups 1 and 2 will be cycled, but not group 4. There are 5 events. Group 1 triggered happens anytime group 1 is triggered. Group 2 triggered happens anytime group 2 is triggered. Group 3 triggered happens anytime group 3 is triggered. Group 4 triggered happens anytime group 4 is triggered. And group 5 triggered happens anytime group 5 is triggered. Let me give you a very simple demonstration. Instead of setting up a complicated scene, I'll just have some text appear on the screen describing our complicated scene. I'll go ahead and drop an event cycler into my scene. In order to use the event cycler, we'll need some events for it to trigger. I'll scroll down toward the bottom of the utilities folder and look for the text maker. I'll drag one into my scene and duplicate it 2 times for a total of 3. I'll select the first one, and for the custom text, I'll type in group 1 stuff is being done. Next, I'll select the second text maker. For its custom text field, I'll type in group 2 stuff is being done. And finally, I'll select the last text maker, and for the custom text field, I'll type group 3 stuff is being done. So instead of creating a bunch of stuff to do, we'll just pretend it's being done. Let's go ahead and set up the event cycler now. With the event cycler selected, I'll expand the first 3 events. I'll expand the group 1 event, the group 2 event, and the group 3 event. Next, I'll drag the first text maker to the group 1 event and tell it to display text. Then, I'll drag the second text maker to the group 2 event and tell it to display text. And then I'll drag the third text maker to the group 3 event and tell it to display text. We'll need something to tell the event cycler when to trigger the next group of events. For that, I'll just use a button. You can find the push button in the buttons and levers folder. I'll go ahead and drop one into my scene. I'll expand the triggered on/off event and drag in the event cycler. Then, I'll tell it to trigger the next group. Let's test it out. Each time I click the button, it will trigger the next group of events. After it triggers the last group being used, it will go back to the first group and continue on with the cycle.